So we're back. We're playing. Last time we unlocked a 3-star restaurant, and today we get to experience what it's like serving in this 3-star restaurant. Today's, or this week's weekly challenge is the Steak and Shake 2 Sprint Challenge. Each wave will end with a random fancy dish. Oh, what? Wait. You can't be serious. These people have been doing these challenges, and the best time... 1-12-14. I don't even know what that means. If that's the leader of 1-12-14, does that mean 1 minute 12 seconds to serve everybody? So that's pretty awesome. I don't know how you do that, but kudos to you, sir. Well, the A button was working. Do any of my other buttons work? Or are we forever stranded at the menu? I think we're stranded at the menu, guys. Or maybe I have to use my mouse to figure out how to enable the controller. So far not looking so good. Does anybody... Oh, gamepad options. Mouse and keyboard. Controller. Yeah, that looks like my controller. Although I don't have an X in the middle. Well, let's check out our other options, though. What else can I choose from? High render, window full screen, anti-aliasing. Yeah, if I get a new driver or something, maybe that could work. Oh. Huh. You can pick a preference here. You can date women or men. But it's still binary. But whatever. Keyboard and tablet options. Yeah, you know if I had a tablet, I'd be trying it out. Or a touch screen. Got high render, 1440p, standard, 2160p. Oh, that would be awesome. So there's standard, high, what are all these options? Standard, high, 1440p, 2160p, and all this. Maybe sometime I'll try it in 2160p. How great would that be? Alright, so how do I get back to the game? Okay. There's local multiplayer. I guess there's no online multiplayer, though. That's a pity. So last time, I mentioned we unlocked a 3-star restaurant. So today, let's give this a go. Oh, hey, look. We got a message. Megan wants to date. Hi, my name is Megan. And I'd like to try one of your delicious nacho bowls. I like nachos. Did I mention that nachos are great? Let's have some nachos. Alright. Hey, if you're gonna pay me money, sure. Why not? And then I'll take nachos off the menu just to mess with you. So the one disadvantage of participating in that program is that now you actually have to put certain foods on the menu. But it's a challenge. Alright, so this wants me to shuffle out the items that have the red marker on them. So I've got to take that out. Take that out. Got to add nachos in wherever nachos went. Where do they go? I'm not seeing them. Did I just imagine that I have nachos? Got fries, some salad, various meat items. Close enough to nachos. No, but what is this? Let's view our foods. Okay, second view what all these things are. Salad, ice cream, nachos. So this thing. I'm not going to make that the... Oh, wine is the daily special. That's awesome. That's a good selection. So this thing is the nacho. Okay, that makes sense. And... do I add this in there? No, I think that's going to be cause too much of a headache if I add that in. But I can add pancakes. Who doesn't like pancakes? Oh. Liking nachos is code for something? Well. Well, I guess leave that analogy there. And get started. Here we go. Begin! Okay, you want queso, olives, jalapeno, and onion. Alright. Coffee with 4 sugars. Beer. Hey, I can serve beer. That wasn't terrible. Is there anything I have to do, like, cooking nachos? Does anybody know how to make nachos, is what I'm asking. Okay. Oops. 3 pancakes with maple syrup and butter. Okay. Queso, sour cream, guacamole, onions. Make a beer. Okay, you want a different wine. Okay, I can give you the wine. Just hold on a second. Here's a beer. Here's a beer. Cheap wine. Sure, here you go. 1 pancake. Browned meat. Queso, sour cream, guac, and onion. Maple syrup and butter. Alright. I'm just gonna assume you want everything. Close enough. Serpent beard wine. Excellent choice. You know, I shouldn't have made wine my special. Oh, hey, look, I burned somebody's food. Well, it's too late now. You're just gonna have to deal with the fact that your food's on fire. Oh, fine. 2 pancakes, butter. Good enough. Cheese, wine. Sure, here you go. 1 beer. Queso. Olives. Onions and ground meat. Alright. Guacamole, jalapeno, tomato. Okie dokie. Just a bowl of chips, nothing on it. Hey, I can actually serve that. Alright, queso and guacamole. Thankfully, I accidentally hit the correct wrong button there. 2,000 hours to start drinking. Wonder what that's about. Oh, until 2,000 hours. I get it. Yeah, I mean, wine is my special on the menu. It's what I'm known for. And they'll pay whatever I charge for it, so it works for me. Serpent beard. Good choice. Queso and jalapeno. Alright. Just assume you want everything. Close enough. Everybody wants the beer. You want everything, right? Oops. Well, I cheesed off one customer by accidentally serving the wrong one. Queso and jalapeno, sure. See, if you want to get served, you gotta order the expensive stuff. Shit. Whoops. Just a bowl of chips. Here you go. One pancake. Two pancakes. Three pancakes. Four okay. Mint chocolate chip with a cherry. One vanilla, one chocolate, cherry, and sprinkles. That's so good, so awesome. Sure. Think you need to leave. Whoops, wrong button. Whatever. It's an endearing character trait that I hit the wrong button. I'm sure she'll understand. Maybe. Probably not. Oops, you got a creamer. Hope you enjoyed it. Hey, I actually earned tips today. Nice. I mean, that could have gone better, but it could have gone worse. Right. Let's just make sure the screen capture still works. Yep, that works with the layout. A 22x combo on 5 days could be done. Oh, one of these. Okay, what do we got here? I'm getting stronger. Okay, sure, if you say so. But yeah, making wine the daily special makes life difficult. Remove that, remove pancakes, because pancakes are a burden. Today's daily special is going to be chicken. You all like chicken. I mean, we're still going to have wine on the menu. We can't do without that. Let's put some burgers back on, just to make life exciting. Okay. Two vanilla and nuts. Yeah, actually, making a simple dish, the special is probably a pretty wise move. Meat and onions only. That's almost onions. Bacon, onions, same difference. Lettuce, tomato, pickle. 2 butter pecan scoops with all the toppings. I have to wash my hands afterward, really? Come on, come on, come on. Let's pour that. Serve that. 1 meat patty. Cheese wine. Meat only. I'll give you a wine. You get a wine. Everybody gets a wine. I suppose you want something in the glass before I serve it. They're also picky. Meat, tomato, pickle, onion. They want me to flush the toilets, and they don't want their food burned. I mean, they have such lofty expectations. Okay, meat only. Nice. Three meat, 1 cheese on top. Because, you know, that's how people like their burgers. Pop this open and then check the grill. Oh, hey, look, I already cleared a 22 combo. Just coffee. You sure? Just coffee, man. That's pretty dark. Coffee and creamer. Creamer is the B button. Alright. I think that was 6. Correct me if I'm wrong. And rush hour. It is at 6 p.m., not at 5 p.m. Bacon, cheese, Swiss cheese. I've never heard of that dish before. Oops, well, that's not going to come out well. Hopefully customers like burned chicken. Open the damn thing. Pour the beer. You get a beer. You get a beer. Everybody gets a beer. Two mint chocolate chips, and that's not mint chocolate chip at all. Sure, close enough. meat, bacon, cheese, onion. There we go. Man, who orders a burger at this hour? Good enough. They're happy. Alright. The people are talking. Oh, nice. Wait, that means more customers. Crap. It's gonna be raining. Megan wants another date? Okay. Yeah, sure. How about this? You must complete all your chores today without missing a single chore and get a 30x combo. Do I go for it, guys? Because I have to put nachos back on the menu, and I'm not so good at nachos. So it's just not going to happen. Tempting, but no, I have to pass. Alright, chicken can still be our daily special. Let's take the burger off the menu. Put nachos in place of the burger. Because Nacho Lady's gonna be here today. And go back and start the day? Or do I want to upgrade anything? Actually, can I get equipment? Pretty purchased all this equipment, other than the stove. I'm not interested in buying a stove just yet. We already have the commercial toilet. To-go service. Already bought all these things. Oh, hey, look. Could buy inspector certification thing. Nice. Sure, let's get that, because eventually we'll appreciate having it. 1700. What do I burn 1700 on? Pizza. Ooh. Ooh, pizza sounds fun. Nachos. We'll get to boost this to $6. Rice, beans, and 6 recipe cards. Sure. How could this backfire? Do we upgrade the nachos again? Shrimp and 4 new recipes. Yeah, let's do it. I'm gonna make the most advanced nachos in the world. Alright. Do you like your chicken on fire? I guess that's a no. Oh, yeah. Yeah, nothing negative can ever come from putting all your eggs in one basket. Coffee and creamer? Sure. I kind of remember how to make coffee. I'm actually kind of amazed that I don't have any fancy coffee options. Shrimp. Okay. Queso, guacamole. I don't know. You want some of this, something. I forgot to put the shrimp on there. And I charged a shrimp price for it. That's awesome. Shouldn't have asked for shrimp. Should have known I don't know how to make that stuff. Queso, sour cream, guacamole, and onions. Olives, whatever. Here's a beer. Two butter pecan scoops with all the toppings. One vanilla, one chocolate, one mint chocolate chip. Okay, I can do that. I wonder, is there... Okay, you want queso. You want olives, jalapeno, tomato, an onion. Oh, we do have onion. Do you like your chicken raw? Because I can give you that. But how great would it be if you had to play this game and coordinate with other cooks, chefs, etc. And you had somebody who was taking the orders, and I mean, you could simulate the entire experience, basically. Miscommunications included, customers asking for really special stuff. I mean, you could do a lot of things to make this game challenging. Other than just making the button presses difficult. Holy crap. Whoops. Oops, we got a dish on fire, guys. I served raw chicken. Maybe. I don't know. Okay, so guacamole, this stuff. I don't know. Left trigger, shrimp. I found the X button. Guacamole, jalapeno, tomato, sure. Okay. Give money to, okay. Queso, olive, jalapeno, tomato, onion. Cool. Onions and ground meat. Bet you want me to serve this to you, don't you? You sure you still want this? I mean, it's after 10 p.m. and all. Okay, here you go. I only missed two chores that day. Your winner. Okay. Hey, it gave me $50, so I can't complain too much. Do no suggest to the dress, and please salute, please and thank easy. Ooh, dude, I could upgrade my pizza if I could afford it. It's gonna rain again. Menu route's occurring, so I better rotate my menu. Hey, we got a safety inspector in. So, you know, I should probably change up my menu. I have to take chicken off, though. Well, at least if I want customers to show up, I've got to take that off. So today's daily special is going to be, I don't know, chicken! Just kidding. Could make it burgers. Could actually make the daily special ice cream, because I'm not too terrible at that. So let's put ice cream in slot number one. Let's put, I don't know, put burgers back on the menu. We don't even need a full menu technically, but let me stick this in here. Actually, wait, what have we got here? Coffee. Yeah, I definitely know how to make coffee. So let's make that the number one item. And put ice cream back there. And maybe I could buy pizza. Fish. Oh man. That looks tricky. What are all these bonuses, I wonder? Thrust L trigger and R trigger. Health nuts. Rainy companion. Yeah, maybe I should get this item sometime. Fresh fish. Can't afford it right now, but I could save up for it. Begin! One sopapilla with sugar. Awesome. See, that's not too hard. Just the coffee? Alright. Hi, Health Inspector. How are you today? Do you want a coffee? Are you sure? I'm pretty sure you want a coffee. See, I serve beer before 11 a.m. Ain't nothing wrong with that. I should have made that my special. But okay. Basically, the only thing I have to not mess up today is just don't miss my chores. If I miss a chore and the health inspector notices, that could be bad news. Meat, lettuce, onions, and Swiss cheese. Oops. You asked for no sugar. One order with sugar. Alright. One meat patty. Cheese wine. One patty. Meat, bacon and cheese, meat only. Come on, come on, we can do this. Meat, tomato, pickles. Why would you ask for that? Something like that, maybe. I don't even know anymore. Coffee, creamer. You sure you don't want just pure creamer? Because I could give you that. I almost did. But the game wouldn't let me. Would you like any creamer in your beer? I could give you that. Meat, lettuce, tomato, Swiss cheese. Oops, I forgot to fill your glass, didn't I? The original's just everything in the left column. That's good to know. Why don't I take care of some of the chores while the customers are away? Fully loaded coffee. That's the American way. The only way that'd be more American is if he skipped the creamer. Just had like coffee and 5 sugar and no cream. That would be the American experience. Meat and lettuce only? What are you, some kind of pagan? No, just kidding. No sugar on top. Meat, tomato, pickle and onion. Cheese, bacon, that stuff. Maybe. I should maybe read what it is that they want. Although at some point I kind of give up on that and just say, you know, if you ordered something that fancy, should have ordered something else. I'm surprised this health inspector shows up so much. And yet doesn't order anything. It's like they don't trust my restaurant, even though we've got like the health inspector certificate on the wall. One chocolate, one mint chocolate chip, one butter pecan, and everything other than nuts and chocolate sauce. Okay, that wasn't so bad. Got a silver ticket. Nice. It's gonna rain again. Pass the inspection. Awesome. Megan wants another date. I'm tired of scrubbing dishes. Oh. Yeah. Get a 40% chance if we fund 250, or if we fully fund it, we're going to get this in 2 days, guaranteed. How lucky do we feel? I mean, I could save $12.50 by not fully funding the thing. Well, actually, so here's how you do the math, right? So there's a 40% chance that you'll get the item. at a price of $250. If you were to scale that up, so 40% is 2/5. If you were to multiply 250 by 5/2, that'd be 625. Would be, I don't know. Would be the expected. I'm not sure how to express that. I mean, yeah, there's a 60% chance that I'd just be blowing $250 and a 40% chance that I get the full value. So my expected value that I'm getting out of this, I'm struggling with the math, but basically what I'm trying to say is that $1,500 isn't worth it at all unless you really, really want it. Like, if you pay $1,500, you get an expected value. We'll say that the item is actually worth $1,500, which it isn't. The expected price I would have of this would be $625 if you were to scale $250 linearly. Anyhow, Scrubber would be an awesome, awesome thing to have. But I don't feel like paying more than necessary for it, so am I going to cheap out? I'm going to cheap out and just fund it at $250 and have a good chance of getting it anyway. So LT is this button. Okay, we'll find out in 2 days if we get it or not. They were to die for. Let's nacho it up again today. Okay, sure. Let's see. Ooh, I could upgrade nachos to $12. Includes beef fajitas, chicken fajitas, and 10 new recipe cards. Sure, there's no way that's gonna fail. Alright. Hey, look, we got a 4-star food. 4-star nachos. So that's gonna be on our menu. Just because I'm tired of reading or something, I'm going to take Sopapilla off the menu and put nachos in its place. Burger might be a bit adventurous. We probably have to take that off. And we'll put chicken in place of where that was. And do I want to put pancakes back on? No, let's stick coffee in. This'll be okay. It'll work out. There's no need to panic. Begin! I like the description of chicken, though. It's that it's like free-range chickens that are well-educated and have a certain reading level. And that have to fight in a gladiatorial school. And those who fail the combat are the ones who you get to eat. Shrimp. Queso, sour cream, jalapeno, onions, beans, rice. Two mint chocolate chip with nuts. I suppose you wanted your food cooked. Queso jalapeno. Ground meat, shrimp, beef fajitas. Sure, some random smattering of this, that, and the other. Ah, shit, I forgot to put the meat on there. Why did you have to order the cheap wine, buddy? Coffee and creamer. Well, I know how to serve that. Queso, jalapeno. Well, it's nice that in this dating or whatever it is, shrimp, beef fajitas. It's nice that in this dating program she orders the simple stuff and pays $12 for it. Queso, sour cream, guacamole. Beans, onions, all the stuff that we cooked. Close enough. The wrong thing. Oops. Oh, I hit the wrong button. Oh well. I'm just gonna have some mad customers, that's all. Queso, sour cream, guacamole, jalapeno, tomato. Yeah, whatever that was. Ground meat. I think I put together too difficult of a menu. I actually read that and I had no idea what it was going for, which is really weird. Queso, beans, ground meat. Okay, that makes sense. I could see somebody wanting to order that. Six bad orders. But I did... Wait, no, I only made a 9 combo today. So much for trying to get a 22. It's not happening today. Iron Cook is now filming. Yay. And it's raining again. Which means I gotta rotate my menu again. Let's upgrade some food, though. Let's see. What... Can't afford the fancy wine thing yet. Get salad that it's, like, ridiculously difficult. Why don't I have salad on my menu? Well, it creates quite a mess, that's why not. Yeah, we can make pizza, though. A surplus of anchovies. Sure. Alright, let's put pizza on the menu. Okay. We're gonna take nachos off and put pizza on, because it's the same thing, but pizza's better. No bias here. Oh. Also, let me move things around a bit to get a little more comfortable. Sit back a bit and relax and enjoy this game. Oh, I have to move the mic a touch, too, so I'm not too far from it. There we go. That should be fine. Have I forgotten anything? I don't think so. I mean, this menu's still pretty crazy, but it could be worse. Begin! Oh, chicken. Game does feature a concept like in terms of comfort foods. So there are some things that people appear to enjoy during nasty weather. So I don't think I have any of those on my menu, which is why my restaurant is sparsely attended at this time. That and the fact that I keep messing up people's recipe requests, food requests, orders. Orders is the right word. Tomato, cheese, sausage, olives, onions. Tomato, cheese, pepperoni, bacon, onions. Oops, I should let the food cook first. Sure, you want everything. Oops, that's not everything. I always hit the wrong buttons. Just the cheese. Tomato, anchovies, and mushrooms. See, it's one thing if I cheese off one customer, but, like, if the dishes don't... if they go without doing, or if people notice rats in the restaurant or notice the toilet's not clean, I suspect that probably affects everybody. But yeah, if I miss an order, it's not the end of the world. Yeah, $12 for a salad. I mean, this is America. You gotta put everything in your salad. And because it's salad, you know it's healthy. So you can put literally anything in it and still call it salad and people will buy it. One chocolate, two mint chocolate chip, all the toppings. All right. Now, I think I'm charging like $8 a beer, just for a single glass of beer. Because it's the Rich Brewski. It's a really fantastic beer. Like, you would not believe what's in that beer. Now we're talking tomato sauce and cheese. I can prepare that. Come back, customer. All right. Anchovies, mushrooms, olives, and onions. Oh, that's on fire. Come back, rat. That rat did not come back. Also, I keep messing up where the Y button's at. Because, it's totally an X button, where it says Y, if you know what I mean. Oh, that sounds tempting. Vanilla ice cream with all the toppings. I've not tried that, but it sounds tempting. See? Yeah, it's the American dream. Although, $12 for a vegetarian salad sounds, I don't know. It's definitely an American experience, but you probably can't find it everywhere. Like, I'd be surprised if you could find such a $12 vegetarian salad in Texas. It's just not happening. Some places you might be able to get it, but I don't think you can get it everywhere. Oh, did I? Oh. So that didn't even cost me any money. That's nice. Burger upgrade available. Nice. Menu rot's occurring. Not so nice. My love for nachos has surpassed everything in my life so much that I'm moving to Mexico and starting my own nacho company. Please accept these tickets. I don't even know if I answered the date properly or not. Maybe she would have taken me with her if I had just answered the questions better. So that's totally on me. But let's check out this pizza upgrade. I could get whatever, a 3-star burger, $25 for a surplus of chicken patties and 10 new recipe cards. That sounds confusing as could possibly be. Get a $12 pizza with ham, pineapple, and 6 new recipes. Well, that sounds challenging. You could upgrade fries, you know, for those of us who like fried food. Could, yeah, let's actually go for the $12 salad. Why not? All right, let's put this $12 salad on the menu. Is this a salad? Yeah, that looks like salad. Do I want the pizza on the menu? Because I'm kind of... Well, it's posing a challenge. We'll put it that way. What else would I prefer? I don't know. Putting the salad in that slot is probably not the best move. Let's put the coffee there. Actually, let's put the beer in that slot. It's got beer, we've got coffee, we've got salad, ice cream. Yeah, that's fine. We can do this. All right, what do you got? Here's an example. Wow, $12 salad. All right, let's see if this salad measures up to that $12 salad. You guys be the judge. Vinaigrette, mushrooms, tomatoes, greens, and carrots. $12. Yeah, putting the coffee in the daily special slot is a good idea. It's gonna make this day a lot saner. I could put wine in that slot like I did on a previous day. Just serve wine and beer and make... Serve wine, beer, coffee, and soda and make that it. And just say, no, we're not serving any food. It's just beverages. That's all we ever serve. It's a juice bar. Juice bar plus alcoholic beverages. $8 for a beer. Hope you like it. All right, who's gonna order our next $12 salad? Thousand Island, X button, cheese, Y button, and everything. Thousand Island, cheese, mushrooms. Tomato, cheese, olives, and onions. B button, left stick. Tomato, cheese, and anchovies. Mushrooms, olives, and onions. Okay, I can do that. Oops. Hope you enjoy paying $8 for a glass that isn't full. Anchovies. All this stuff. Bacon and mushroom. Oh, we do have mushrooms. Thousand Island, cheese, and everything on it. Okay, I missed an order. Sorry, customer. Tomato, anchovies, and onions. Well, that's almost anchovies and onions. One butter pecan, and all the toppings except for the ones that you don't want. Close enough. All right. Why do I put leeches on the pizza? I don't know. People want leeches, so you gotta get the customer what they want. Bacon, mushroom, and badger. Oh yeah. $12 for tomato and cheese pizza. Hope you enjoy it. See, you would have ordered nachos if I had them on the menu, but I didn't, so you had to order the pizza. Although it was the same price, so it's not like I did anything clever price-wise. Set traps for the rodents. Alright, we can do that. vinaigrette and cheese. Well, that's interesting. Why would you want that? But okay, if you want it, we can give you that. Yeah, that vinaigrette and cheese salad, $12. Vinaigrette, cheese. I hit the wrong button. Oh, ranch, greens, and carrots. Vinaigrette and cheese. Hang tight, people. Sure, you get some of those, some of these, whatever. Ah, you want the super fancy wine. I can give you that. Thousand Island. Cheese. Whatever. Anchovies, mushrooms, all this stuff. Three chocolate, okay. Okay, what do we got here? Trying to find a place to play Go online. Oh, I guess I would recommend the online Go server. Look for OGS. Or I think it's an online-go.com, I think. But yeah, it's a place for beginners to play Go. Sausage. Mushrooms. All the stuff. There we go. Tomato. Cheese. Bacon. I don't know why you'd want anything more than just bacon. Like, the minute you put bacon on it, why not just get, like, double, triple, and quadruple bacon? How about a quadruple bacon pizza? How about just a big slab of bacon you stick in the oven instead of a pizza? Everyone is thrilled. Except, oh. Okay, had nothing to do with my services. They just fixed the elevators. That's awesome. Okay, so they have a boost in patience, which means I could put awesome, challenging stuff on the menu and customers will stick around until I finally serve them. Okay, I need to rotate my menu again. Sure. Let's put beer back over here, coffee over here, and put chicken in slot one. Unless I feel really ambitious, I could put wine in slot one, because all the customers are going to be really patient today. That could be fancy. Or I could try to challenge myself a little bit. Yeah, let's make this as challenging as possible just for laughs. Although I am going to keep beer here, but the rest of this is really challenging stuff. I could put burgers and, you know, why don't we do that? Let's just see how challenging we can make this menu. Alright, so we got chicken, we got lasagna, got burgers, salad, nachos, and wine. Got all our high star foods today. We're gonna fail most miserably. This is the most predictable result ever. Here we go. At least chicken's in slot one. So chicken's not too hard to make. It's just really high priced. Cheese. Bacon. Onions, tomatoes. Oh, I failed on the first dish of the day. I'm sure that's not an omen in any way for how the rest of the day is going to go. Thousand Island. Cheese. The Y button. Greens and carrots. Guacamole. Jalapeno, tomato. Hey, I got it. All right, meat, lettuce, pickles. Ground meat. Queso, sour cream, jalapeno, ground meat. Oops, that didn't cook. Beef fajitas and ground meat. Almost. Shrimp and beef fajitas. All right. Ground meat. Jalapenos, rice, chicken fajita, shrimp. Well, that's almost chicken fajita. Ground meat. Oops. Vinaigrette. Cheese. Onions and peppers. Come back, garbage. Don't go away, my trash. All right. Jalapeno, onions, and rice. Ground meat. Okay. They want Italian-style nachos, whatever that means. Meat, bacon, double cheese, tomato. Queso, olives, onions, and ground meat. Uh-oh. All right, here comes rush hour number two. Vinaigrette, cheese, onions, and peppers. Lettuce, bacon, cheese, tomato, meat and tomato, meat, lettuce, bacon, cheese, tomato. Vinaigrette, mushrooms, greens and carrots. Come back, rat. Alright. I thought everybody was going to be patient today. Bacon and cheese only. Cheese, bacon, onions and tomatoes. Ground meat. Olives, onions, and ground meat. Chicken fajitas. Close enough. Don't order complicated things if you don't want me to mess them up. Meat, lettuce, pickles. See, I can do that. Vinaigrette, cheese, and everything? Okay. Highest combo today, 13. Income for the day, $891, because I served all the really expensive dishes. Whoa, congrats! Okay, cool. Oh, we got another safety inspection coming up. Statue maker. Wait, what? I love making statues, but I feel the restaurant industry is neglected in the art of statue making. Well, obviously I can't fully fund it. Can't even, yeah. So what's the deal with the statues? How does that help my restaurant? Oh, increasing their patience. Well, that would be fantastic, except I can't fully fund it. I can attempt to fund it. We'll give it a try. It'd be awesome if that did get funded, but odds are 4-1 against, so I wouldn't bet on it. All right, see you around, Elsie. Ooh, tacos. Man, that sounds good. Upgrade foods. Do I have 900? Well, I've got $900, but it doesn't really upgrade anything other than fries. Sweet potato fries, and the addition of sugar. Everything's better with sugar. That actually draws a night crowd, so maybe that's something I should consider buying. So that we don't have everybody show up at exactly the same time of the day. What are all the other bonuses on this? Green. Oh. That's nice. Alright, so fine. We'll upgrade our French fries. What's got to go on the menu? Because it said menu rot is occurring. Okay, we're gonna take nachos off the menu because it's just causing a ridiculous headache. Dare I try this? Yeah, sure, why not? We're gonna fail everything because now the customers are less patient than yesterday. But you know. Hopefully, things will still work out. It's one sweet potato fry with salt. Place in bowl, add salt. Wait, I thought I had multiple types of fries to... Don't I get to choose between types of fries? Where's the button to choose that? I mean, fortunately, it had the sweet... Okay. I guess that's automatically decided for me. That's really helpful, because I was thinking it was going to force me to decide what type of fries I wanted to use. Like here, it forces me to pick the right wine bottle. Dude, it's America. We put sugar on everything. Oh, I never noticed that until now, that that popping the bottle actually animates. That's really cool. It's also funny, hang on, hold that thought while I go serve all the things. Bacon pickles. Okay, you want something? Thousand Island cheese and everything. Well, that's close enough. I forgot my own thought, though. Maybe it'll come back to me. Probably not. Yeah, we put sugar on everything because it's America. You know, the music makes this game so intense. Really, it does. That and the controls are really... green. Controls really... I don't know. The controls plus the feedback in the controller itself give you the sense that you're actually doing something. There's a constant sense of feedback and thought. Each recipe has its own combination of buttons. Yeah, I was saying it makes you choose the correct bottle for wine. And there is, I mean, I've never selected the wrong bottle yet. I know it's eventually going to happen, but I don't know how it charges the customer in those cases. Thousand Island, cheese, bacon, onions and peppers and all that. Half the fun is there's no time to read anything. Although, sometimes you'll recognize some of the more common recipes by their name. Like, there's three types of lasagna that I make. One which has the name Meaty in it. Shit. I just missed a whole bunch of orders. That's fantastic. At least the health inspector didn't seem to notice. So that could have gone badly. Thousand Island, cheese, mushrooms, and tomatoes. Okay, we can do that. Yeah, there are certain combinations which are more common than others, for sure. Let's see here. Yeah, apparently, this game doesn't have a multiplayer mode. Onions? Swiss cheese. That sounds disgusting. But okay, if you like it, sure. Oh yeah, so I made $800 that day, despite flubbing 3 orders. Get a silver ticket. There's gonna be rain today. Menu rot's occurring. Pass the inspection, because you weren't paying attention when I goofed. Okay, what do you like? What food do you want? A delicious soup. Yeah. I don't actually serve soup, you know, so that's great and all that you like soup, but, yeah, I can't actually take you up on that because my restaurant doesn't serve soup. Yeah, the lasagna building is really a mess, and you can actually see, like, here you can view and buy foods. And so here you can practice like building some of these things if you feel so motivated. And so now we're practicing building lasagna. So there's a vegetable lasagna, which is you put pasta, sauce, veggies, and you just repeat that. But you have to put veggies in the middle of the first two layers. And if you mess up any single step of that, there's no going back. So, like, if you put things out of order, they will complain. So this is the extra fancy thing that allows you to charge extra money, where you put meat on layer 1 and veggies on layer 2. And see that guy there? He's just gonna order every dish. And I could purposely mess things up too. Like if I say pasta and I add cheese, I have to go to the next layer of pasta, sauce, cheese, and so forth. And then you get to hear his judgment on it. But yeah, if you start adding other things, if you start putting things out of order, the game will call you out and say you completely messed it up. So he reorders the same dish. Here you just spin the left stick. It's a very difficult dish to prepare. Oh. Maybe I just wasn't reading that correctly. So yeah, you can wait. And then you can see this is cooking and cooking, definitely cooking pretty well. All right, and yeah, now that we're red, that's the last opportunity to catch it, and so forth. You get the idea. Oh, right, I was saying I was going to save up for fish. Whatever. I'm sure eventually I'll buy the fish thing. But yeah, the graphics in this game are pretty cool, right? One sweet potato fry, and just sugar. Alright, don't fail me now, controller. Just sea salt. I have to place it in the bowl before I can serve it. Or before I can even flavor it. Dude, it's not even 11 a.m. and you're buying the cheap wine. What's going on in your life? Do you commute to work or something? I suppose you do. Because otherwise you would have, I don't know. You could have purchased a bottle for your own home consumption. You don't need to come here to eat, drink cheap wine. Well, maybe it's a social thing, but you came here alone. So what's up, buddy? Now we're talking. You want the fancy stuff. But again, why don't you just buy this on your own? Vegetable lasagna. El cheapo wine. You want the cheap wine also. Okay. Okay, you want Thousand Island. Cheese, greens and carrots. I suppose you don't want your food burned. Meat, lettuce, cheese, and Swiss cheese. Come back, customer. I screwed that up. Whatever. Maybe I just let that one burn. Thousand Island, cheese, greens and carrots. Yeah, that's just gonna occupy a slot there. That's one less customer for me to worry about. Oops. Dishes need cleaning. Hope that customer's patient. Vinaigrette, cheese, onions and peppers. Yeah, see if I burn it enough, maybe they won't notice that I put the wrong things in there. BLT, bacon, lettuce, tomato and cheese. Alright. Trash is piling up. Oh, hey, look, it's totally catching fire. A customer's only been waiting here how many hours for it? I wonder, can I burn down the kitchen if I'm just negligent enough? We're gonna find out. I'm surprised the customer hasn't left. Oh, yeah, yeah, no, it's cooking. Don't worry about it. Don't worry. It'll be ready any minute now. But yeah, that's one less customer for me to worry about. All right, here you go. Here's your food. See, had I only not served that, I could have got a longer perfect combo. Oops. Suppose they want their food cooked. Damn picky customers. Alright. $3,000. Bacon, croutons, stuff, I don't know. Here you go. Ranch and cheese. Here you go, here's some food. Pepper ranch. Ranch cheese, onions, peppers, something. Patty. Oops, that's a little overcooked. There we go. One meat patty. Meat only. Bacon. Tomatoes, cheese, and lettuce. Meat and lettuce only. One meat patty. Meat, bacon, double cheese, tomato. There we go. What's up with these customers wanting their food cooked anyhow? They don't want it overcooked either. They're so particular about what they want. They should just be happy to be here in my fancy 3-star restaurant. Yeah, basically. I mean, I'm surprised you can get away with burning down the kitchen like that. But hey, also, if you had any other commitments, yeah, that's just not happening. Pickles, onions, sure, here you go. And we end the day with a 12 combo. See, we got 4 bad orders, but no very, very bad orders. So, and we made almost the same amount. Usually, on a really awesome day, we're making 800. I totally got your back. Oh, nice. Can't make more than 100 in tips today. Yeah, you're right. Weather alert. It's gonna rain. Menu route's occurring. Funding failed! Okay. Yeah. Odds were 4-1 against that was gonna be successful, so. Let's get fish. People want fish? Although, can we afford steak? Yeah, we can. What are all the positives of steak here? The Big Tipper, Health Nuts, Competition. Oh, it's a competition level item. Attracts VIPs, but it takes forever to cook, and it causes me to use more plates. Whereas fish. Fish, on the other hand, secures big tips. It's good for rainy days. Health Nuts like it, attracts VIPs. This makes me have more trash and more rats. That's minus 5% for morning hour traffic. You know, since we can afford it, we're gonna get steak. It's upgradable. It's got a base price of $10. Actually, that's the same price as the other thing, right? And, I mean, ultimately I will need that, but I'll have more disposable money if I actually just buy the fish thing now. So let's save steak for a little while from now. Get fried chicken. Fried chicken's cool. What's all our problems with fried chicken? It's really easy to make. So why have I not got it? Oh, because originally I had a policy against fried food. You never get a tip for it. And it's only a 1-star recipe. So it's not going to be something I can hold on to. This goes up to 4. This is a base price of 6. Yeah, let's get steak. Steak sounds fun. And it takes forever to cook, so that actually might not be a bad thing. Active menu. We've got to take chicken off the menu, got to take lasagna off, got to take fries off. Game is telling me that people are tired of seeing those 3 items on my menu. So let's make steak our number 1 item, or a daily special. We'll add coffee back on. What else can we re-add? Oh, has beer been off my menu? Whoa. That's really messed up, man. Yeah, steak can go to 5. Here we go. Begin! Great button. Hmm. season 3 times. One juice. Okay, just let that cook for a while. That's actually not too hard to make at all. I mean, sure, it takes a long time, but... Oh, wow, that catches fire very quickly, though. If I'm not careful. 1,000 islands, cheese, and everything. Thankfully, X and Y are reverse of each other on the controller. But yeah. Once seasoned, twice juicy, one citrus. Okay. Ranch, greens and carrots. Once seasoned, twice juicy, once citrus. Meat and tomato only. Oh shit. Things are catching fire, maybe. Well, I can serve the other things even while I'm at my prep station. I can serve other dishes. It's gonna take me some getting used to that, but yeah, I can use right button to serve one dish while I'm still preparing another one, which is really cool. Thousand Island, cheese, and everything. It's a nice little rag there, too. Three cubes of sugar and one tiny cup. You saw the other customer. They wanted 5 sugar. That's awesome that they want that much sugar in their coffee. I mean, why stop at 5? Why not just fill the whole cup with sugar and just add in a couple drips of coffee? I mean, that would be the American way. Although, you could probably fit more sugar in if you'd poured the drink first and then just pour the sugar. Seasoned, twice juicy, once citrus. Okay. Ranch and cheese. Putting all those dishes in a row like that was probably unwise. Meat, lettuce, pickles, meat, bacon, cheese, tomato, meat, lettuce, bacon, cheese, tomato. Okay, can do that. Cheese, greens and carrots. But yeah, the thing for like taking out the trash is the opposite set of buttons as the thing for washing dishes. So one requires you to hit the buttons in one order, the other requires them in the opposite order. Oh, I was going to say earlier that some of these, where it says it involves both the X and the Y button, that's really a good thing. Because you can accidentally hit X or Y first and then apply the other one later. So, yeah, somehow, magically, I got a perfect day. Only $39 in tips, but only $600 in income. But not a single missed order out of 52 orders. But yeah, I guess having steak on the menu really slows down the menu. Iron Cook is filming. I can accept the challenge if I desire. Oh nice, $250 bonus. We'll take it. Can we upgrade our fish thing? Which I still haven't put on the menu, because I forgot. Apparently not. Oh, I didn't buy fish yet because I bought steak. That's right. Fish costs $1,500. Soup here still requires me to purchase a thing, a stove. I mean, you could sample what's it like to make soup. Chicken, bow tie noodle, bouillon cube, and celery. 1, 2, 3. Left button to cook. Oh, I have to press RT with the knife to cut it. Well, whatever. We messed up on that. Let's try this again. Soup de jour. Bowtie noodle, bouillon, seasoning, and carrots. You have to use the right trigger to cut it. Oh, that's right, knife cut. Celery, tomato, and then cook. Yeah, so you can see that that's a little challenging in that and uses pretty much all the buttons at the same time. And this guy wants soup du jour, seasoning, and then three of everything. And then you have to wait for it to cook. And yeah, once it cooks, there's how much time until it like catches fire or something. I don't fully understand this. I mean, yeah, it is possible to overcook soup, but it should not overcook as quickly as other things do. Maybe it doesn't, I don't know, but yeah, it's definitely difficult to make. So I'm not in any hurry to add that. In fact, you see an indicator over here. A squared C cubed over 4z with an argument of whatever that is on the right. It's pretty messy. And it causes a mess in terms of, well, it takes a long time to cook. And it causes trash. And it uses dishes. So it's kind of a mess. You don't want it. I could add chicken, but chicken's eventually going to go by the wayside as soon as, well, stuff happens. Should we try one of the extra events? So, we've already completed all the catering events. Could try the Iron Cook Studio. I've already beaten the diner challenge. Here we go. The Iron Cook Challenge. Must survive 5 waves of foods. They're the most popular things. We'll be upgrading this challenge, adding to the difficulty. Get all of them perfectly, with no more than 2 average or bad orders. Just do your best. Bacon and cheese only. Olives and onions. That's wave one. That's wave two. Doo-doo. Pepperoni, sausage, bacon, mushrooms, olives, and onions. Oops, that's not good. Shit. I think I failed the challenge, guys. So that's something I'm gonna have to come back and... Well, I could try it again. Maybe I'll have better luck this time. I'm thankful that it allows me to try the challenge over and over. One meat patty, one meat patty, bacon, mushrooms, tomato, cheese, sausage. Meat, bacon, cheese, tomatoes. Wave one complete. Wave two, here we go. Shit. That was a really bad one to miss. Alright, you gotta do everything perfect from now on. Anchovies. There's the Y button. Bacon. Mushroom. Pepperoni. Sausage. Bacon. Mushrooms. Onions. Olives. Yeah. Now that's super challenging stuff, man. Should we try the Italian challenge? And see if that's any more difficult than the American challenge. It probably is. Boil raw pasta. Oh yeah, that sounds difficult. Cheese, chicken, bacon. Chicken? Bacon? Okay. Cheese sauce, chicken, and bacon. cheese sauce and onions. Cheese sauce and onions. Okay. That's wave one. Red sauce, meatballs, and spices. Spices? Where's spices? There's spices. Red sauce, bacon, and red pepper. Yeah, whatever, I missed that. Red sauce, meatballs. Whatever, I failed. Yeah, so you see, these involve some reading comprehension. Thankfully, it does allow you to retry the events, but man, that stuff's difficult. So maybe I should delay attempting that for quite some time. Yeah. Obviously, the American challenge was easier, if we learned anything from it. It was good to try it. Okay. What should I put back on my menu? I'll take coffee off and put steak back over here and put coffee. I'm sorry, not coffee. I want chicken in slot one. Anything else? I mean, this is probably fine. Can I upgrade anything I'm currently serving? No, not really. Can add ham, pineapple, and more recipes to pizza. But yeah, I hope that some of those technologies that... how is the nachos setting? Are selling. Selling like hotcakes, except I'm not making either. Nachos are difficult. If you want, I could add them back on. They could be fun. I mean, that's more fun than salad, right? So where's nachos? 4-star nachos. Totally worth it. Here we go. Man, whoever worked last shift left a whole bunch of dishes and trash and all that just lying around. Oh wait, that was me. Yeah, everybody wants nachos. I don't know why. But it's good for me to practice trying other dishes. Because, you know, I'm never going to beat the Iron Chef challenge unless I manage to master all the dishes. 2, 3, and 1 juice. Let that cook. Man, people are using the bathroom a lot. Is that saying something about my food, or is it just weather-related, or what? It's the food. Chicken fajitas. So sour cream, guacamole, tomato, onions, beans. Oh, you probably want the chicken on there. Um,
ground meat. Meat and lettuce. Okay, I can do that. Queso. Olives. Olives? Onions. Ground meat. Ground meat, chicken and beef fajitas, sure. Queso, sour cream, jalapeno, something, something. Rice, onions, olives, something. Almost. Yeah, you wanted something like that. Meat, bacon, cheese. Hope you guys like your nachos. If you don't, go to like Taco Bell or something. I'm sure they'll serve you food. I sell only the most improvised nacho recipes. Well, see, the thing is, you can't just leave it dirty, because the customers will notice. You can't just lock the bathroom, unfortunately. Even if you could, it's probably not too much work to actually... Oh, I remember why that customer was so angry. It's because they asked for a dish that had so many meats in it. And I didn't add any meat. Queso, sour cream, guacamole, olives, jalapeno, tomato, onions, ground meat, and shrimp. Close enough. I think some of these dishes are kind of challenging. It's like the developer of the game wanted to prove a point that you just can't do this. Beef fajitas and ground meat. Oops. Queso, olives, jalapeno, tomato, and onion. Beans. Beans, beans, beans. Beef fajitas and ground meat. Catch up on some of these comments. Also, to increase profit, start filling the beat one level from the top every 8 or so, or the beer. You'll have another for a leftover beer you could sell. Yeah. Every 8 or so, you'll have enough left over for another beer you can sell while on the clock. Right. Yeah, I mean, that makes sense. It's good to get those beers served while the clock is still allowing you to serve them. Hey, look, we can upgrade the steak. Your video revenue. Your revenue report for your 15 videos is attached. Okay, I made 20 bucks somehow. I've got to rotate my menu again. And we could buy fish. Let's do it. Why not? Who needs to practice dishes before serving them? Me, obviously, but I'm choosing not to do it. Okay, so we take the burger off, put ice cream back on. And I'm leaving nachos on because it's profitable, even though I can't serve the dish correctly. There are some things you can upgrade. Surprisingly, I have not been able to get the dishwasher yet. It's a technology that really hasn't been invented in this area of the country, apparently. There are Kickstarters or campaigns or whatever it's called to discover dishwashing technology. But as much as I've tried to fund said campaigns, I have not ended up with said technology just yet. So that can deal with all your chores, but I don't really think there's anything to improve the cooking. I think the cooking is just difficult, and there's nothing you can do about it itself. Other than try to invest in things that make your restaurant look nicer and distract customers from the fact that it's taking so long. If you've got a nice place, the customer won't care that their dish takes forever to prepare. Or if it's a really good day. Shrimp? That's not shrimp. Okay. Close enough. Open the damn bottle! Queso, sour cream. Yeah, you want some of these, some of those. You want all those. Almost. That was almost what they wanted. Fillet the fish and season and cook. Hopefully that rat will just stay there. I don't know why the rat trap thing has to be done immediately. Of all the chores, that seems like the one that doesn't have an immediate effect. Like when you discover a rat in the trap, sure, you have to clean out the rat. But preparing a new trap shouldn't be a really demanding task. Onions and ground meat. Oh, that's right. You want your meat. But yeah, while I'm prepping one dish, I can still use the right bumper to serve a different dish. If it's already been fully prepared. So like while I'm doing this, I can serve that, which is really nice. I'm sure there's some more clever way to do it, where you arrange your menu such that half the dishes, two butter pecan, cherry, whipped cream, and nuts. Okay. I'm sure there's some way to arrange it such that half your dishes require prep and the other half the other half don't require extra prep or something, so
There's got to be some clever way to maybe soup falls in that category too. Things that you just have to serve them once they're prepared. But anyway, I was gonna say maybe there's some way that you can arrange for half your dishes to require lots of prep, and the other half to just require you to make sure to time it carefully. I'm surprised I'm able to get the wines accurate so frequently. Like, given all the other things I'm messing up, you would think that it would not be a slam dunk, but apparently it is. Also, why can't I attend to chores while I have my prep station open? I'm confused about that. Rice and ground meat. Close enough. Chicken and beef fajita. Come back here, toilet. Oops, I forgot to... Queso, beans, rice, beans, and beef fajita. Chicken fajita. Close enough. Chicken fajitas. Alright. Hey, look at all that money we're raking in tips. Queso, sour cream, guacamole, tomato, something, something, beans, wrong button, and chicken fajita. Close enough. Queso, sour cream, olive, jalapeno, onions, beans, and rice. That was almost it. Okay. It's not terrible. Made $700 that day. Liquid pin. Not sure what that achievement refers to, but I'm getting lots of perfect combos. In spite of all the dishes I'm messing up. With steak and chicken. That's truly a ridiculous bet, because I could easily do that. Okay, we'll take the bet. Menu rot's occurring, safety inspection's coming up. Click and start profile. My name is Bethany, and I'm a scientist in the field of sanitation. I feel there could be much more work done in the way of being able to prepare or being able to have more sanitary food, and I want to prove it by researching your food menu and providing you with a cleaner way of storing preparing foods. Interesting. So the only benefit of this is that I'm less likely to fail a safety inspection. Right? Well, I can't even afford to fund it. Well, that's unfortunate. Yeah, now I'm constrained on funds, so I can't do that. Sorry. But yeah, I've not yet failed a safety inspection, so that's cool. I have to take nachos off the menu. Darn. Gonna add steak back on, and do I take ice cream off? Yeah, I think I do. gonna make this as simple as possible. Hit coffee back in. I might make steak my number one. Although, really, chicken's not that hard to prepare either. There we go. Alright. Can you set up a macro? Yeah, that would be an awesome way to play this game. A red dolphin safe t-shirt. I mean, who wouldn't want to wear a red dolphin safe t-shirt? Once season, twice juicy, and once citrus. Also, I wonder if Crazy Dave is one of my clients. Or if he's doing these bets impartially and not influencing the bet in any way. Because I could see Crazy Dave coming in saying, you know, I'm just going to order the most complicated thing on the menu and make sure you fail the bet. I mean, Crazy Dave just could be crazy enough to do that. But yeah, it's a shame I spent all that money gambling. Else I could have afforded that better food sanitation technology. With a 70% chance that it would actually be delivered. Well, we're almost at 30 combo, so we've almost won the bet. If I could just get four more simple orders, that would be fantastic. It's a nice little swaggy ragtime meat kind of tune or ditty. You notice I slow down just a little bit as both this is a quieter hour of the day and I really want to get that combo. So I'm just trying to be careful and deliberate. Here's our combo. Now if I could get a perfect day, I get an extra bonus. I'm kind of close to doing that. The reason I'm so close to doing that is because I don't have very many customers because I'm not rotating my menu as much as I should. For a 3-star place, you would think that I would not serve the same dish every day. Because if you wanted the same dish every day, you'd just go to McDonald's, really. Or to any fast food joint.
Man, I'm surprised only one person ordered coffee today. And they ordered it not at the beginning of the day, but at the end. What's with this town? Yeah, perfect day. Not as profitable a day as most, but I did win a bet. And I'm going to get some kind of bonus because of my perfect day. Alright, the reviews are in. And I seem to be an awesome restaurant. Well, we already knew that. Soup upgrade available. Well, I don't have soup. 250 bonus. Woohoo! Menu routes occurring. Inspection passed. And, of course, I won the bet. Yeah, that was a really stupid bet. Because chicken and steak are some of the easiest dishes to make, at least as it stands right now. Sadly, I missed out on that technology opportunity because I couldn't invest in it. I could upgrade my fish, double the price. The long body grown racuda. Fish can create an even bigger portion to enjoy, and its pleasant taste is miles beyond the gray tail fish you're accustomed to serving. Upgrade comes with a surplus of long body brown racuda fish to replace your gray tail line of fish. Really, there's no downside to doing this, and people still tip for fish. So that's money in the bank, really. Alright, so what do I gotta rotate on my menu? Am I forced to rotate fish off the menu? Yeah, people are tired of fish at the moment. They're also tired of chicken, and who can blame them? So let's put burgers and lasagna back on the menu. And if I'm feeling silly, I could put nachos back on the menu. Yeah, let's do that. We got nachos. And let's put fries back on the menu. And I think that's good. It's a really pricey menu. I don't really enjoy making lasagna though, so let's add ice cream back on instead of lasagna. And let's see how much money we can make this day. Well, ice cream probably makes about the same as lasagna here, so let's just go. Here we go. And there's less of a chance of me flubbing it up. One meat patty. I forgot to check what my daily special is. I suppose we'll see what the customers order the most. Meat, tomatoes, pickles. I might have accidentally put the burger into the daily special slot. Which, if I did that, it's gonna be... yeah. That's gonna be an experience to be remembered. I'm gonna suffer a lot reputation-wise. Because there's no way I'm gonna be able to keep up with that. But you know, burgers make money. Bacon, lettuce, cheese, and tomato. So it's the whole left stick there. Everything in the left column. They just want sugar. Sugar, here you go. I mean, who gets sweet potato fries with sugar? Does anybody actually do that? Meat, tomato, pickle, and onion. Cheese, bacon, lettuce, tomato. I'm missing something there. Meat, lettuce, bacon, cheese, and Swiss cheese. Bacon, tomato, lettuce. Bacon, cheese, and Swiss cheese. One meat patty. Two meat patties. meat and some stuff. Here you go. Here's a burger. Meat, something. Pickles, whatever.
Oh, you want the serpent beard. Here's a serpent beard.
But yeah, there's a reason you don't put all your 4-star items on the menu at the same time. As I've been doing here. Just for comedic effect, really. Ground meat. Jalapeno, ground meat. Come back here, rat. Ground meat, bacon, lettuce, tomato, cheese. You want salt on your fries? Well, too bad, we're out of salt. Just kidding. Queso, beans is the Y button. Rice and ground meat. Alright, shrimp, alright, salt and sugar, oops, that was not salt and sugar, onions, beans, chicken, beef, and shrimp. That's not right. 2 mint chocolate chip with a cherry. 1 sweet potato fry with sugar and salt. Okay. I can do this. I can do this, maybe. Beef fajitas. It's the Y button. 1 meat patty. Queso. Beans and rice. Beans, rice, queso. Guacamole, olives, some of this stuff. Rice, beef fajitas. Meat, lettuce, tomato, Swiss cheese. Here's a beer, queso, beans, rice, something. Yeah, this is not my best day at the office. Bacon and cheese. Want a wine bottle. And meat. Here's a beer. Here's a beer. You want a meat. Meat, cheese, pickles. All the stuff in the left column. Meat, lettuce, bacon, cheese, tomato, pickles. I missed. Here you go. All right, see you around. Have fun. Meat, cheese, other cheese. One chocolate, 2 mint chocolate chip, and all the toppings. Okay, we can do that. Ground meat. And I suppose you're going to want something else with that. Or is it just going to be ground beef? Queso. Beans. Y button. Ground meat. Nice. Alright, how much did we break in today? Oh, really? So even with my super expensive menu, I only got $700. And I messed up 6 dishes completely. Well, that's funny. Iron Cook is now filming. Oh, great.
Oh, the cool thing about the filming is that I can attempt the things over and over. That's the point of the whole filming thing. If it were live TV, I'd just be screwed, but, yeah, $1,500 to upgrade my fish. Lemons. Not just any lemons. These are Australian lemons. Fresh from the lemon fields of Sydney. Get these from the Down Under fruits on your seafood menu today. Does that really justify... I mean, why would I get that? Other than it's a 3-star dish. I could upgrade my pizza. Yeah, having fancier pizza would be awesome. Although that's going to make pizza way more complicated. Yeah, sure. I guess let's upgrade the fish dish. Because why not? And... yeah, I accidentally put the burger... in the daily special slot, which just hosed me for the day. There was no recovering from that mistake. Let's get steak, get fish, fries, ice cream. I mean, this all looks good. And one more day, here we go. And sweet potato fry, and you actually want sea salt. Who asks for that? What kind of hippie are you? Just kidding. Ooh, got fish. Fillet the fish, then add lemon and cook. So you don't want seasoning. Okay. Can deal with that. Just sugar. Oh, maybe you do want seasoning on it. You didn't say seasoning. Maybe you didn't want it filleted. Maybe you just want raw fish. Once seasoned, twice juicy, once citrus. Okay. Come on. It did say season. It said it right in the middle, and I didn't read it. That's a pity. That. Take care of that. You want a lemon with it. Really, that's the only difference between the two recipes is does it have a lemon or does it not have a lemon? Because nobody wants the gray fish. I am noticing, though, that these fish dishes result in less trash and less dishes to clean, and it's just a lot simpler. So that's pretty cool.
Also, it's nice how I can, like, add the sugar on as I'm serving the dish. It's too bad this is not a perfect day, as I did miss the first dish of the day because I couldn't read it. That's kind of a pity. A wasted opportunity, but... oh well, what you gonna do? Although it seems that since I've only got 28 in a row, I must have messed something up midday. I wonder what. Or has it just been a really slow day overall? It could be. Oops, that guy asked for no lemon, I give him a lemon. He's not gonna be happy. Yep, there goes my perfect combo. Shame on me. Alright, all the things are cooking. Whoa, whoa, whoa. I'm not gonna let everything catch fire. As tempting as it is to try that. Okay. Only 1 hour to go. I like all the little tunes it's got in the background. It's really nice. And the fact that it varies the tune from stage to stage is kind of nice, too. Oh, no bad dishes. See, that should be a bonus right there. Income 781. That should give me a bonus for each rat I trap. How great would that be? Crazy Dave's bet. 40 combo. Yeah, okay, you're right. Ooh, I get a nice contribution. Can't decline that. Okay, well, I think I can't upgrade anything at the moment. I could buy a stove and start adding things like soup on, but I'm afraid to add the stove, because pasta and soup and all that are really complicated. And this game is supposed to be a casual game. So, practice chores. We haven't done this one in a while. See, you got, like... he's got sexy hair. He's got normal eyes. Round ears. Fancy nose. And a beard and a mustache. And small lips. Yeah, we caught him! Isn't it great how we get to practice these robberies? You look crazy. You got crazy eyes. Where's crazy eyes? B. But bald. So he's got no hair. Normal ears. normal nose, long lips, and a beard. It's exactly what he looked like. The bald guy... Oops, that's not it. The bald guy, normal eyes, but long ears. I saw his fancy nose. His beard and mustache own the place. Small lips, too. Yeah! Anyway, that's what it's like if you get robbed. But you know, it's obviously a big deal. It's never happened in this game. Not once. I mean, you can check all the statistics. Let's see how many foods I've served. Wow. Food volume statistics. And it keeps track not just of... Well, that's not volume. Whatever. Whatever. American foods, 1,168. Oceanic foods, 52. Mexican, breakfast, exotic, and liquid. Huh. Pins are awarded after 1,500 plus dishes are served. So I've been serving tons and tons of beverages, so of course I get the liquid pin. I got quite a ways to go on these other things, but yeah, these pins I assume are similar to achievements. Got a checklist. So these are next things for me to aim to attain, or our next objectives. We're close on the 20 days of service, and pretty close on safety inspections. However, we have not passed the Iron Chef filming challenges. Should we try one more of those? Let's give one more a go. Where would I go? Let's see, back to modes? No, that's right. No, that's not where I wanted to go. Can I abandon or abort the day? Apparently not. Although I seem to have locked up the day. Okay. Yeah, so I can quit that day. Where do I go to the challenges? Extra events. There we are. Let's try Iron Cook Studio. Alright, and we got a fried challenge. Fry me to the moon. Alright, fries will be upgraded within this challenge. Here we go. With sugar, you say. With sugar. So far, this isn't too hard. Next wave. One fried chicken. One sopapilla, but no sugar. One sopapilla with sugar. One with sugar. One with sugar, please. Alright, wave three, here we go. Normal salt. No salt. Normal salt. Sea salt. No salt. No sugar. With sugar. And with sugar. This doesn't seem too hard. Gotta be honest. Sea salt, please. Just sugar. Sea salt. The thing that's actually making this tricky is navigating down the menu there. Wave 4? Or 5? Salt and sugar. Salt. And fried chicken. Yeah, there's really not much you can do to make this challenging. It's just fried food. You always just have to dunk it and then later on add whatever it asks you to add. Alright, so we passed the fried food challenge, which is supposed to be challenging. Obviously not as challenging as its other events, but, you know, it can be appreciated for what it is, I guess. So we could choose, do we want to upgrade fish, or do we want to upgrade steak? Ooh, this would significantly increase the steak price. Spicy pepper. And two new recipe cards. Yeah, that sounds great. So yeah. See, here's our checklist. We still have two more Iron Cook challenges to go. One more safety inspection and two more days of service. So if we can get that, we will have a 4-star restaurant. But that said, obviously, to complete the Iron Cook challenges, that's going to take a ton of work. Or maybe some easier challenges are going to have to open up, because the American and Italian ones are actually kind of challenging. I mean, I guess that's why it's called a challenge, right? Anyhow, it's been fun. But I think I'm going to call it here. Because we've been going for a while. And because... it just causes a bit of strain if you keep playing the same game over and over. So I'll have to come back soon, and come back perhaps with a different game. So thanks for tuning in, hope you guys enjoyed it, and let me know what game I should try next, or play next. I'll see you guys next time.